Good evening and welcome to another episode of the BashTalk podcast. This is episode number 23. It's been a long time coming, but it's a catch up with professional MMA fighter Shoaib Yousaf. I've had him on as a guest on the podcast before, but it's time to catch up with him again, as quite a lot has changed since our last episode. It's been more than a year, about a year and a half.
Yeah.
And we're now sat in your very own establishment and training centre now, so how's that going for you?
Yeah, alhamdulillah, it's good. Just opened recently, so still like trying to sort out the class times and the gym times, but soon like we'll have a proper timetable set up.
That's good. And how are you finding it, knowing that you've got a place just around the corner from home?
Yeah, obviously for me, I'm still travelling to do my training, but it's more for the community and people to come and train. And if I ever want to do my own thing, I've got this as well, so it's brilliant for me.
Right, good. And then since we last spoke, you've also now become like a regular member of Manchester Top Team as well, haven't you?
Yeah.
What's that, 9 a.m. every day, like a pro?
Yeah, so the class starts at 10.
Right.
So I have to set off about 9 o'clock. But yeah, since then, I don't think I was at Top Team. I wasn't, yeah, and I've just started Top Team, so that's who I represent now. If I'm in the UK, I fight out of Manchester Top Team.
Cool, and then you're going abroad like very, very soon, aren't you? Which is why I've got you on the last minute to do this episode, because I know that once you're gone, I ain't going to see you for a while.
Yeah, so I'm due to fly out tomorrow. So I've also been to Sweden since the fire had a brave and... So I went once for about 2 weeks to try it out, and I think before every fight I'm gonna go do a camp there. So when I'm in the UK, obviously I'm with Top Team. So when I have a fight scheduled, I'm gonna go for a couple of weeks in camp and then come back, finish off here and fight. That's the plan now.
Well, cool. And when you were at Sweden last time, because you did your camp there last time, well, a short one, didn't you? You got to train with like Hamzat Shimaev and quite a few others, didn't you?
Yeah, so they got a lot of fighters coming and going, because one of the best gyms in Europe, and now it's famous because of Hamza.
Yeah.
So there's Hamza, Gulam, a lot of these UFC fighters and other fighters coming in and out.
That's good. And then obviously our Top Team, you've got some really, really good fighters as well. So it looks like things are coming on the up and up for you then.
Yeah, even our Top Team, I think, is, from my opinion, one of the best gyms in the UK, especially around our areas.
Yeah,
like you got UFC fighters, Bellator, and even people coming from other countries now to train our Top Team.
That's really good. We met a few people that came to the opening of your facility the other day as well. So since we did last speak, you've had a couple of fights, a couple of ups, a couple of downs.
Yeah.
What have you learned from it?
You can learn everything. Like for me, even in my wins, you can learn. And again, losses, you can learn more. So there's a lot, and obviously the situation with the fights, like COVID and the training, and it's like people just think, oh, you fight and that's it, but it's the leading up to the fight, and like a lot of other factors are involved, not just the fighting.
Yeah, I think unfortunately people think that you just got a nice easy training session, get a few sweats on, take a few clips, and it's like, I'm ready to fight next week.
Yeah,
it's a lot more to it.
A lot more.
The strength and conditioning, you got to taper down, you got to slow your diet out, cut that weight, and then you might have an opponent pull out, and then you're back to eating again. And then within a space of a day or two, they'll be like, actually, we've got someone.
Yeah, that's exactly like obviously with the COVID situation, it doesn't help. So the last 2 years, I've just been like just training and just stay ready in case you get the call to fight.
So you don't even get to enjoy putting a bit of weight on either. You just got to stay in shape.
Stay ready, yeah. So.
Yeah, don't know how you manage it.
But you know, man.
Actually, that's true. So, you know, with obviously some of the training that you've done and some of the areas that you're focusing on, like last time when we talked, you were saying you're obviously quite well-rounded and you don't specialize in one specific aspect. But based on how you've been fighting, is there something that you're going to be focusing more on in future?
Obviously, for me, I think in the UK, the wrestling isn't as good as the other countries. Like, obviously, look at the Americans, the Russians.
Yeah.
So with me, I always think everything needs to be, like, if you ask me, I need to improve on my wrestling, striking, jiu-jitsu, everything. But like, that's why I like All-Star as well, because of they got a lot of these Russians there. Mm. And they like on here, you know, wrestling was,
yeah,
even
yeah,
striking,
yeah,
everything, jiu-jitsu. But I like the way they train hard. So I think that fits perfect. Even Manchester top team, you got a lot of like UFC, Bellator, high level fighters. So it's just good to mix up with them.
Okay. And then you're also teaching some classes here as well. Well, whenever you're in the UK, you've got some kind of classes going here. So what can you tell us a bit more about them?
Yeah, so obviously we still try to figure out some times, but mainly I'll train in the morning, like go Manchester, whatever, and then again about 4 or 5 o'clock I normally train. But here I'm planning on doing like MMA classes and kids classes. So like one day grappling, one day wrestling, one day striking, one day sparring, and then a few kids classes just to mix it up for everyone, so all they right. can. And even when I'm like going for training camp abroad, whatever, training myself, we love other people just running the classes.
Yeah, that's good.
So it'll always be running. Even when I've gone, it'll still be.
It's a good opportunity for people from the local community if they've always wanted to learn about martial arts.
Yeah.
And they get to learn it from like professionals and people who've got a lot of experience as well. And then also, it's not just for boys, is it? There's this facility that you're going to have private classes for women, I believe.
Yeah,
as well.
So women hopefully is going to be in the morning. So we don't know the times yet, but
of course,
about 9 till 1, for example. So that'll be just women.
Yeah.
And then obviously in the evenings will be for the men.
Okay.
So it's like separate time for women. The men won't be coming there then.
Okay. Just for the benefit of the viewers, I think one thing I probably should have mentioned is they've only kind of opened the facility, it was just a Saturday past gone.
Yeah.
So it's literally only been like less than a week. And they're just in a position where they're kind of sorting out the timetable and the scheduling and just trying to get in a position where you know you've got some kind of regular classes
going.
But it's just obviously just to let you guys know that there is stuff in the pipeline. Well, speaking of stuff in the pipeline, what's coming next for you? What's your plans and goals for the rest of the year? We're already in January, after all.
Yeah, so hopefully, inshallah, trying to fight one more time for Ramadan. That starts in April.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm flying out, so I can go train. So even if the call comes, I'm ready.
Yeah.
So around the end of March will be good for me. So that's the plan, but I've got nothing concrete yet.
So you're just going to be walking around like about 4 or 5 kilos over the weight then, aren't you? Just ready?
Yeah. I think I'm a bit heavier, but but I need to, like, training, diet, everything, just in case, like, oh, you're fighting in 4 weeks or 3 weeks or... But inshallah, before Ramadan, trying to get one more fight.
Yeah, and then... So, one of the questions, and I think a few people want to know about this in general as well, is obviously MMA is quite a few different disciplines, and you've had to learn them individually as well as combine the skills as well. So one of the questions I had, and a few people that also aspire to get into this have as well, is just around how you go about choosing your style in each one of those disciplines. So like, if we start with striking, you strike a certain way.
Yeah.
Some people are counter strikers, some people are a bit aggressive and prefer to go in and attack. Like, what would you say your style is striking wise, and why?
I think with me, I am aggressive when it needs to be, but I'm more of a counter fighter because I'm for a featherweight, I'm quite tall. But again, it depends on your fighting. So if the guy's shorter, obviously I want to use my range. Some people are one of the guys I fought, although I'm a tall featherweight boy, he's like 6'2" in the South African guy. And it depends. If I then I had to, like, I couldn't just, he was out, his range was too long for me. So it depends. But I've always been a big fan of Aldo, Jose Aldo, so I tried to like mimic him. It really just depends who you're fighting. And you just switch it up. But I'd say I'm more of a counter, but when I'm aggressive as well, so if I hurt someone, I'll try to go for the finish.
Okay, so basically you're kind of adjusting for your opponent.
Yeah.
But your base, would you say you're a bit more of a counter striker?
A bit more of a, yeah.
Okay, so that's the striking. What about the grappling aspect?
Don't like people don't know, but I started off grappling. So when I was, I think I was seven when I started grappling. So I've been like grappling way longer than I've been striking. But then I think I just had that switch that I started enjoying striking more.
Okay.
But I think alhamdulillah with the grappling, like on the floor, I can do it off my back or on top. But it's the wrestling, I think that I can improve everywhere. But like I said, the level of wrestling here isn't as good as some of the other countries.
Okay.
So that's like somewhere to work on.
Okay, and if so, wrestling is something obviously, like you mentioned, you want to work on it. But stylistically, there's the Dagestanis and then there's the Americans. The Americans tend to be like super explosive, very kind of power.
Yeah.
And the Dagestanis, it appears or seem to be a bit more like kind of like half speed, repetition, flow with it.
Yeah.
It looks a bit better, but both of them are as brutally as effective. Yeah. But which would you prefer?
I think now the Dagestanis are they're good at mixing it with MMA, like since Habib, like they're trapping arms and punching. So the Dagestani, I'd say they, like now they're just one step ahead of everyone during the MMA aspect. Like they'll just get you to the floor, like lock you up, like control you with their hand, whatever, one free hand, start punching. So I think their style is better for MMA.
I think a lot of them are there, especially the ones with like the sambo base.
Sambo basically is MMA, ain't it? So they've been doing sambo since they're kids.
It's like
they got the judo, wrestling, everything.
It's a good base.
So I think they like these Russians, man. They're one step ahead of everyone.
Yeah, and then actually, have you done sambo?
No.
Actually, to be fair, there's not really a lot of places to do it here, is there?
Yeah. MMA.
So there's a job in it. But yeah, so just to round off the chat that we're having, I think one thing that stayed with you, win or lose, is you've always had that support. And it's like a big range of, and it's not just people from Nelson either. Have you got anything to say to them or anything to say about them?
Yeah, alhamdulillah, I have a big support, like I said, local, especially in Nelson. And I just want to thank everyone that supports me, sponsors. And it's just good, you know, like when a community is behind you. Even like, because I'm like a Pakistani as well, like Pakistan, this, that. So alhamdulillah, I want to thank everyone for this support.
That's what. So it's been a short and sweet episode just because Shoaib has literally messaged me today saying I'm flying out. I was like, in that case, I better come see you.
Yeah.
That's why I thought I'd get a quick catch up with him, because once he's gone, he's gone. And I probably won't see him till after Ramadan, or probably later than that even.
I'll see you before then, Bash, inshallah.
There'll be more content to come. So that's episode 23, wrapping up, over and out.